The Farmers League is not actually a league full of farmers. This is a derogatory term used by football fans to describe a football league, usually professional, that they don't consider to be competitive. Examples of such leagues are Liga, dominated by PSG, Bundesliga, dominated by Bayern München, Croatia, dominated by Dynamo Zagreb, and you get the idea. But it would all be too easy if we would only refer to these leagues as farmers' leagues. In today's video, we are going to look at 5 other leagues in this situation, hopefully 5 that are not that obvious, and list key areas that are going to help you dominate any of them. The Welsh First Division is made up of 12 teams, and while, at the surface, it looks like an amateur league, it is pretty competitive. Connacht Quay, Bangor and the New Saints have won in the most recent seasons, but as you can see, TNS have dominated the 2010s. Connacht Quay started to overturn the dominance a bit, but when you are a semi-professional club, like other 10 clubs in your league, it is quite difficult to pose any problems long term. TNS is the only professional club in the league, and this helps a lot, especially in attracting the best players they can possibly sign from Wales. Comparing Connacht Quay and TNS, we can see that not only the squad is better for the Saints. Financially speaking, TNS have also secured a sponsor of 82k euros, while Connacht Quay has none. Dominating the league for so long also enabled the Saints to compete in the Champions League. And, while they have not qualified to any major stage of the competition, even participating in the qualifying phases means that they have received the revenue they could not secure otherwise. If you wish to attain the same dominance as TNS, you must make sure that you set as objective to become the best of the rest, build the best squad you can, develop the facilities over time, which leads to developing players, which can lead to profit. After establishing financially, you can ask the board to upgrade your status to professional. Once you get to the professional level and you can apply this cycle efficiently, you have started your dominance. Managing in South Korea is different than managing in Wales. They are a fully professional league. What is also the difference is the subscribe button. Clicking it does not guarantee winning the South Korean league, but ensures you don't miss any future videos. Back to the K-League, there are 12 teams in the league and Chungbuk Hyundai Motors dominated in style for the past 4 seasons. Compared to Seoul and Pohang, Chungbuk is not better. The only difference comparing them is that Chungbuk has made sure they are financially stable. Pohang even have a 900k euros debt. They need to pay 67k euros per month until 2024. This means around 600k euros per season. Being financially stable and not debt-ridden helped Chungbuk attract better players. And if you manage to raise the level of the players you attract, then the level of football increases. They have 11 star players. Not all of them can play at once, but if they could, they'll make for a full first 11. When the club can attract this kind of level of players, the level of football increases exponentially. There are signs coming from Ulsan that they could potentially fight to overturn Chungbuk, but if you wish to dominate this league or any other league like them, you need financial stability and leading or star players in the squad. The Romanian First Division is a mixed bag. Ridden by debt, lack of footballing talent and vision, it is far behind its glory days of the 80s and the 90s. Lately, the glimmer of hope came from Cluj. The local club, CFR Cluj, is the one that dominates the league for the past 4 seasons. In the past, FCSB or Dynamo Bucharest have won the league too, but the Cluj-based team surpassed them in recent years. Being managed by the Romanian legend Dan Petrescu, the former right fullback instilled in the team a sense of professionalism that is different compared to other teams in the league. However, CFR Cluj have a 14 million euros debt, and compared to FCSB, they are in a worse financial situation. While Cluj have the best players in the league currently, things can get overturned if you would manage FCSB or any other club in the league. As long as you make sure you attract stable revenue, and you either grow or buy better players, you could manage to surpass CFR. The Romanian league may seem easy to dominate at first, but without financial backing and with a reputation closer to Serie B than to Europe's elite, it would rest upon you to build any of the clubs. With good applied tactics, stable revenue and developing or attracting better players, Dominating the Romanian First Division is possible. The Israeli Premier League is formed by 14 teams and is currently dominated by Maccabi Tel Aviv. Hapoel Beersheva had a spell of 3 consecutive title wins, but Maccabi Tel Aviv reclaimed the trophy. There seems to be a battle developing between Maccabi Tel Aviv and Maccabi Haifa for the league domination, but Maccabi Tel Aviv still have the upper hand in terms of finances and facilities. In terms of players, Maccabi Haifa have the better ones and seem to have the momentum. Hapoel Beersheva, though, is well behind the two teams in terms of finances and squad. To succeed in the Israeli Premier League and to assert dominance, the key details to pay attention to are a very good squad for the league level and stable revenues. Adding to them is a great development center. The Israeli football is well known within the FM world for its footballing talent. So, if you'd manage to develop youngsters, you have a platform to either play the youngsters or sell them for profit. However, surpassing Maccabi Tel Aviv or Maccabi Haifa will prove difficult. And at number 1, we have the Austrian Bundesliga. 8 consecutive title wins and 12 in the space of 15 seasons. Red Bull Salzburg is asserting a level of dominance over the league comparable to PSG or Bayern München. Being backed by a giant corporation obviously helps. RB have the best finances in the country, possibly, and this was built on the basis of developing young talented footballers and selling them for profit. Erling Haaland and Takumi Minamino are just two of the many players developed by RB. Having money of course helps, but having the vision and strategy that go with the money is just brilliant. SK Rapid Vienna is trying to catch up with RB Salzburg, but without a stable revenue, with financial debt and a vision that cannot be supported by other factors, will be very difficult. The Austrian Bundesliga might be the only league on the list about which I can say that one team will be dominant for seasons to come. To overturn them, you need the same kind of vision backed by financial power. Until another club rises, RB Salzburg seem to be the most dominant team on our list. But in case you wish to take a club from any level of football and develop it to the highest peaks, make sure to watch this video next. The story of Villarreal is an inspirational story of resilience, good decision making and trial and error. I'm Alex and I thank you for watching today's video. Until next time, dear audience, stay safe, relax and have fun!